Well, change of pace now, but here is a very sobering statistic. More than 200 native Australian birds are under threat of extinction due to climate change. But can we turn things around?
Well, let's find out. Let's catch up with our bird expert and author of Your Backyard Birds, Dr. Gráinne Cleary. Gráinne, so lovely to see you this morning, but this is really sad news. 216 bird species under threat. That's a heck of a lot of species. It's not all doom and gloom, though, because Conservation Action has saved 23 of those over the past decade, which means it's not too late to turn things around, right?
Exactly, and that's what I'm here to talk to you about this morning. It's not too late. We can still do something to help change this and help save our birds.
So can you explain the direct impact climate change is having on our native birds?
OK, I know it's very early in the morning, but basically what's happening is the baby birds are being boiled to death in their nests.
Oh,
now, that's a little bit graphic and a little bit much for this first thing in the morning, but this is why it's so important to act now with climate change. Birds, especially mammy and daddy birds, have to spend more time trying to cool down. So for a bird to cool down, they'll often open their mouths because they don't sweat the way we do. Instead, they'll open their mouths to kind of let cool air come in and let hot air out. And they spend more time doing this instead of feeding their babies because mom and dad have to stay cool. So that's one of the direct actions climate change is having. Indirect action is the removal of the native vegetation, the overgrowth of habitat, of bushfires. So our birds are very stressed out at the moment.
All right. So, Gráinne, what species of bird are under threat and what does under threat actually mean?
So when we talk about birds under threat, we're talking about a few of our honey eaters, we're talking about our thornbills, our fairy wrens, and even some of our parrots. And it means that their numbers are going down. They're not breeding as they should do. We're not having the young being produced as we should. They're either breeding too early in the year, which means their main food source isn't available. So they're breeding, then they don't have food to feed their chickens or their nestlings. That's one of the main effects of climate change, as well as the heat and just the lack of water available to birds.
Now, this gorgeous little fairy wren, which we're looking at now, is dying younger due to the climate warming. Can we, like, just as individuals, can we do anything?
Absolutely. We can absolutely help this. One of the big ways we'll do this is by voting. Vote for your politician, your candidate that takes climate action seriously. Vote for your politician that wants to retain our Native Vegetation Acts, our Native Wildlife Acts. We've got to get action at the federal and the state level. And us as individuals in our back gardens, we can absolutely do things to help.
In fact, you say the situation is so bad, Gráinne, that parrots are changing their body shape to cope with climate change. In what way?
Yeah. So this is fantastic. So if you ever watch a bird sleeping, it will usually turn its head and nestle its beak into its back. So the beak is an area that loses a lot of heat. It's how the bird loses heat through its body. And what it will do is it's actually growing a larger beak, so there's more surface area for the bird to stay cool. So this is okay for parrots, but other birds who have a very specific diet and their bill is very specific for that food won't be able to adapt as quickly as some of our parrots are doing.
Jeez. That's incredible. You mentioned that we could do things in our own backyard.
Yeah.
We're looking at a lot of bird baths in the pictures there. Are they the sort of things we can do to help?
So absolutely, provide water in your back garden and provide a few different sources of water. Provide some water up high, some water down low, and in vegetation. Build up your garden with lots of structures, lots of places for birds to build nests. Keep your cat in, keep your dog in, give the birds some space in your back garden. And yeah, in urban areas, what you do in your back garden can really help what birds survive. So yeah, we can definitely do things, providing water, increasing your vegetation, keeping your animals in at night, and cats especially during the day even.
Yeah. Gráinne, what are bee eaters and what's so significant about them breeding in England?
So this is a great story. So in England, there's not many birds, and the birds we do have are little small brown jobbies. So suddenly these honey eaters are appearing in England, and everybody's going mad. If I was back in England, I'd be going down to see them. And they're coming up from the Mediterranean because the Mediterranean has gotten too hot for them. So they're like, Spain, you're too hot. I'm chilling out in England with me mates. Come on! And they're actually finding the cooler areas they need and their food in areas such as Britain. And Britain is very excited about this. And we are trying to protect them. And we're hoping that they'll breed and raise their nestlings. And this shows that the birds can move to cope with climate change. They do move to different areas. And this is what we're seeing in Europe. They're moving more northern, into England, into Ireland, and even into Scandinavia to get away from that hot climate of Spain and France.
Aren't they clever?
So clever. We love your passion, Gráinne, and you've got a new book coming out. You've got a new book coming out soon. Tell us about that.
So the book that I have coming out in October is Why Do Birds Do That? It's all your questions. When you ever wondered, why is a bird doing that? I've got the answer for you in this book. It's been an absolute joy to write. And I'm telling you, together we can turn back climate change. I just sat my citizen exam. I'm becoming a citizen of Australia. You ain't getting rid of me now. And together we can work towards saving our birds. Absolutely.
Wow. Oh, you gorgeous woman. Hey, when you're on the book tour, you have to come to Sydney and see us in the studio, Gráinne. It's been too long.
Oh, I will. I will. Don't you worry about that. I'll be up to see you to teach you more about your birds.
Oh, we love you. Dr. Gráinne Cleary, thank you for chatting with us.
My pleasure. Anytime, and have a great day. And working together, we can save our birds. There is still hope.